Welcome to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Super Talk Mississippi 93.7 Spotlight is on Northwest Community College, and you can listen to our live stream at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Here's your host, Gary Darby.
That's me. It is time to chat for this hour as we start at 9:06 on your Thursday, September 9th. In the year 2021, the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour underway and full of good information again. Today, we have Lieutenant Colonel Danny Robbins, U.S. Army retired, the new Veteran Services Coordinator for Northwest Community College. We'll talk with him about the new position. We'll also talk about his being in service in our armed forces and get a nice discussion with the Colonel coming up here in a few moments. And then our friend Patti Gordon returns. Patti is the Executive Director of Institutional Advancement. We'll talk about next week's 2+2 golf tournament. It benefits students with Northwest Community College and the Ole Miss University of Mississippi students at the DeSoto Center in South Haven. All of that information coming your way on today's program. Colonel Danny Robbins first, and then Patti Gordon after that. Right now, though, from the LitcoBuildings.com studio, we're looking at 82 for the high. 82. Tonight's low, we're going to find ourselves back into the 50s again. 55 degrees for the overnight low. Tomorrow, a little bit warmer, but not much. We will, in fact, 82 is the expected high today, 84 Friday, 86 Saturday, 88 Sunday, all with sunny skies. Low temperatures in the 50s today and tomorrow in the low 60s over the next couple of days. Weather is a service of Pickens Pest Control. We tell you about them almost daily. They do the job. They do it well. If you're in this listening area, give Pickens Pest Control a call. It's P-I-C-K-E-N-S, Pickens Pest Control. I'm sure you see their vehicles roaming up and down our North Mississippi roadways. 662-234-2207, 234-2207. Let them deal with your pest problems. Taking a look at MDOT quickly, you know the locations of all of the rather large construction areas around Holly Springs and all of their exits on I-22. On Interstate 55, right now we're seeing Panola County doing some work with the right lane closed in both directions there at exit 237 south of Batesville, the Pope exit. And, of course, they've got the big roundabout still working on Highway 7 between Oxford and Water Valley. All of that's going on for you to pay attention to. Plus, your cities may be doing some work along the way. Just buckle it up. Drive as safely as you can. Northwest football's back at it tonight, and they are up to number 2 in the current NJCAA rankings. Snow College is number 1. I think that's Utah. And then Northwest comes in at number 2. All of the first place votes went to Snow College. Northwest is number 2. Mississippi Gulf Coast, who shows up on Northwest's schedule later in the year, is number 6. And tonight's opponent, Jones College, is number 15. So the Rangers have their hands full with tonight's game in Ellisville, number 2 versus number 15 in game 2 of the season. The Rangers won 31-12 last week over Colin. Jones beat Northeast 41-17, both with impressive wins in week 1. Live stats and broadcast links at nwccrangers.com/watch. nwccrangers.com. Kickoff from Sim Cooley Field in Ellisville is slated for a 7 o'clock start time. If you plan on going, you do need to go to either nwccrangers.com or the Jones website and buy your tickets online. You won't be able to do it if you walk up down there, as I understand. Long ride to Ellisville, so you need that information now. Have those tickets, go online and get that done. For the second consecutive week, Northwest women's soccer midfielder Jennifer Enriquez has been named the Offensive Player of the Week by the Mississippi Association of Community Colleges Conference. The league announced that on Tuesday morning. Enriquez is a freshman from Las Cruces, New Mexico. And she's taken the conference by storm. In her first five matches, she has a hat trick already. Three goals against Colin, two assists against Southwest Tennessee. And for the season, six goals and six assists for the women's soccer program, who are off to a great start. We've had Coach on with us several times on the program as we look 5-0 so far on the year with wins, Blue Mountain, Meridian, Colin, Southwest Tennessee, and St. Charles on Monday, a 6-0 win. Next up for them, however, tomorrow is at number 2 East Central in Decatur, 5 o'clock. That's the start time for that one. So you might want to keep up with that. A chance for the women's soccer team to become a nationally ranked. They're getting votes towards the poll. And they take on number 2 East Central tomorrow in Decatur. Good luck to the Northwest women's soccer team and Coach James Beattie, who's been on this program a couple of times before. What reminds you of those kinds of things and more before our show is done, I'm sure. Today, again, our guests. First, we're going to talk with Lieutenant Colonel Danny Robbins, U.S. Army retired, the new Veteran Services Coordinator at Northwest Community College. He's up next, and then we'll get Patti Gordon, the Executive Director of Institutional Advancement. We'll be talking about the golf tournament coming up 1 week from today at Cherokee Valley in Olive Branch, what the 2+2 scholarship means, where it goes, how you can help benefiting students at Northwest and at the DeSoto Center as well. So we'll get into all that information in the second half of the program. But next, let's meet Lieutenant Colonel Danny Robbins. He's on the show next. The show is called Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, and we're glad you're with us on this Thursday.
This hour is everything Northwest. Your connection to Northwest Community College and powered by Sycamore Bank. Thanks for joining us on the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Join the conversation by texting 662-426-1093.
The Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. You listen to it on Thursdays between 9 and 10 right here on Super Talk Radio in North Mississippi 93.7. You know all the ways to be involved. You can stream our program at supertalknorthms.com. Excited to get a chance to meet for the first time Lieutenant Colonel, U.S. Army retired, now new Veteran Service Coordinator. Danny Robbins is on the program with us. We have talked to Dr. Ginger Robbins. I assume you know her, huh?
Yes, sir. Just a little bit. Yes, sir. She's my wife.
That's right. That's right. Well, we have spoken with her a few times along the way. Now we get to see it. See if you can be as good a guest as she is.
I doubt that, but I want to try. Thank you.
All right. Well, we welcome you to the program, and we thank you, Colonel Robbins, for giving us some time today. And, of course, we are approaching the 20th year of 9/11, and we have you to talk with us a little bit. I want to get that background information on you, your time in the Army, and then we'll get into what you're doing at Northwest Community College. But if you don't mind, give us some background information for the listeners, please.
Yes, sir. Well, I always like to start and give credit for beginning my military career to my brother. He's 2 years older than me, and he had joined the Mississippi Army National Guard as a high school senior. And so when I became a high school senior, he took me to one of his drill meets on the weekends where they assemble. And I guess just something just clicked for me because I really liked the order and the discipline that I saw there. And I guess that's very good for a high school senior that really doesn't know what they want to do at that time. So I joined the National Guard right as a high school senior. I stayed for almost 29 years with them. And so about 6 of those years were part-time. Then I served about 23 years full-time. And so early on, I did get to serve in a lot of local areas. So I am still local to the Senatopia area, but I got to serve in New Albany and Ripley, Holly Springs, Batesville. And so a little later on, I got transferred to Central Mississippi with the National Guard. I've had a variety of assignments, you know, over the 29 years, as you can imagine. Very good, all of them, very interesting. But I've been very fortunate that some of those assignments had to deal with soldier education and training. such as teaching college ROTC. I got the chance to teach high school JROTC. So I guess I've just developed a passion for assisting military members and young students, you know, as they complete their education and training. And so I guess all of that has just led me to being here.
So tell us, have you been deployed? Did you have to leave the states at any point?
Most of my training has been here in Mississippi, but I was able to deploy during Operation Iraqi Freedom. I deployed with the 168th Engineer Brigade out of Vicksburg, Mississippi, and I served as their S1 personnel officer. We deployed in 2003, so we were one of the first units to go. We got to see quite a variety of different things. We were deployed for about 14 months, and we served in Kuwait and Iraq, and we had a great mission. I will give great accolades to that. We had a great mission in Iraq. Our units were construction engineers, and so we got to, we were about 3 weeks behind the main assault, if you can remember, going through Baghdad area. And so the role of our engineers was to clean up those roads and bridges and debris, get all the burning equipment off of it so the rest of the U.S. forces could come through. So it was quite interesting going through and seeing all what our infantry and tanks and armor units had done. And so that was really good to be able to see that in real life. And great unit there in Vicksburg. Great people.
Talking again with Colonel Danny Robbins. He's with us, the new Veteran Services Coordinator, Northwest Community College. We're going to get to that in a moment. You spoke of the junior ROTCs in the high schools, and I know in being in sports and going through and watching, and, you know, obviously they're there during the national anthem and different things, but watching them drill and do things even prior to that, are we still seeing a good number of high school kids joining into the ROTC programs?
We are, yes, sir. Here in Mississippi, large numbers. We have, I believe, about 82 units. That's high school units in Mississippi. A lot of high schools would love to have more units. There's just not enough funding through the Army to provide that. But the numbers are there. High school students are loving to join. You know, it's a leadership program, and that's what it teaches them. It's not a recruiting program of any sort, but it instills leadership in those young students, and they come out, and they're all much better for it, that's for sure.
Let's talk about Veteran Service Coordinator, that title that you've added to your list of things. What exactly do you do on the Northwest campuses?
Well, you know, here at Northwest Community College, like other community colleges, we have a variety of veteran students. And so, for instance, some have joined the National Guard right as high school seniors, such as I did. And then some have went on after, you know, high school. Maybe they've served 4 or 5 years. And now they're coming back, and they want to pursue their education. So that's where I'm going to play a major part in it. And so, like I said, I've been around education in the military world for many years, and so I do have that strong passion. But because of their military service, they've earned certain education benefits, and it can get very tricky, you know, to navigate through all those those roles and things. So one of my major roles, I'll be assisting those veteran students with their certification, using all those education benefits, helping them, advising them, and giving them guidance on how to do that and when to use it and when not to use it. And, you know, because we want them to have a great experience in college and get that degree, hopefully not come out using, spending a whole lot of money and that kind of stuff. So that'll be one of my major roles. Sometimes it is very helpful for those veteran students to speak to someone that has been in their shoes before and that can share that military experience that we were just talking about. You know, some of these students, they've deployed, you know, to Afghanistan and other places real recently, and they have a real experience to share with people, you know, so that so for them to have someone to speak with, you know, that is very meaningful to them.
What kind of benefits or financial aid would be available to a veteran?
Well, most of them earn, there's about 4 or 5 different types of GI Bill that are out there. and they're very complicated. And so that's why sometimes having someone that really understands how those programs work is very helpful. They will pay tuition and fees and books, stipends. A lot of them will pay housing allowance, depending on what chapter of a GI Bill they're using. The one that's the best is the post 9. Well, it's not the best, but it's a great one. The post 9/11 GI Bill. It's transferable to your dependents. That entitlement is, and so we actually have a lot of veteran students here that are going to school using GI Bill, but because of their parent, what they did in their service.
Wow, we're talking with Colonel Robbins here, Northwest Community College, and getting a lot of useful information, because I guaranteed there are people that are out and listening right now that might, you know, be in the National Guard, might have served, and they're back again, and they're looking for, you know, what that next job is, what that next step in life is, and we're trying to lead them to Northwest Community College. You mentioned it. Is it a difficult process, or a process that is easily navigated? Because, I mean, I'm sure there are some extra things that a veteran has to go through.
Well, the process can be difficult, and that's part of what my role is going to be here, is to do to help them navigate that. Northwest has a great situation and environment for enrollment and navigating all those processes. But for instance, with that GI Bill that's transferred to your dependents, the veteran themselves may not need that benefit, such as that was my case. I didn't need the educational benefit, but after I got back from deployment, my son did. So I transferred all my GI Bill that I had just earned from going to Iraqi Freedom to him, and he was able to complete a whole 4-year bachelor's degree with it.
Wow. Excellent. It's good to know that they are giving some, because so many times we hear, you guys get lost in the system, right?
Yes, sir.
And whatever that system might be, you go to wherever it is, and, you can go back to our fathers and grandfathers and what they did and when they came back and how they were treated. It's good to know that you could transfer that to your son, who's now made that into a 4-year degree.
Yes, sir, and that's exactly right. And I wanted to also mention another thing our leadership here at Northwest is doing is to further their commitment to the student veterans is not only is creating this position, but we're also establishing a Student Veterans Resource Center here on the Senatobia campus. This is going to be big because it's going to be like a one-stop shop type situation for assessing all those benefits, for that veteran student to come in and get academic support. The center will be a place for them to study, socialize with other student veterans, which is very important because of a lot of things that we've been talking about, to share their experiences and things. And so that's just outstanding that our leadership here at Northwest is supporting, veterans and military students in that way.
Without a doubt. I mean, we talk on this program a lot about Dr. Michael Heindel and what he is doing. The past presidents have done great things in leading Northwest, and now seeing him lead us into this year and further at Northwest Community College and the things to come. If you will, what is a way that someone could reach you to talk about things we've been discussing, or the best way to go find, and I'm already on the website, northwestms.edu, where I'm looking at, to certify your VA benefits at Northwest, what's needed and different information. But if you don't mind, could you go through those for us?
Yes, sir. Well, and that's one of the things we are going to be working on is updating some of our websites. But like you said, our webpage is our website there in Northwest is one that you can go to quickly at northwestmississippi.edu. Mm-hmm. And most of our information currently is over under the financial aid tabs. And so if they'll kind of research a little bit over in that area, they'll be able to find us. We're in the process, like I said, of that center, and so setting the center up. And we'll have to be able to provide more information to all of our students because, like I said, this is a relatively new situation that we're doing here.
Well, look, I want to thank you again, not just for your time and talking with us and your job at Northwest Community College, but for the service and for talking with us about what men and women like you have seen in the past or going to see in the future. And now the Northwest has that great center coming up and you to help lead some of our veterans to get that education started along the way. A big thanks for everything you've done, Colonel.
Well, thank you, sir. And I do want to say thank you again to our leadership here at Northwest. Like you said, Dr. Heindel, our president, you just can't ask for any stronger support than what they're doing to veterans and military students.
You're listening to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, your connection to Northwest Mississippi Community College on Super Talk Mississippi 93.7 and stream live at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour.
Please do that and be a part of this show and everything else that we do. 9:33, and I'm looking at a beautiful forecast. 70 degrees in some of our areas, still upper 60s in most of North Mississippi. 82 and less humid on this Thursday. And let's hope that next Thursday, as we extend it on out, which shows 85 with a few clouds, it's going to be just as nice because we have a golf tournament to talk about with our friend Patti Gordon, who's back with us. How you doing, lady?
Good morning. I'm doing great. I'm like you. I hope we can reserve this day for 1 week from today for our golf tournament.
Well, you know, it looks like we're going to be decent, right? 85 for a high, so early morning golf, things of that nature should be fine with a few clouds. They're starting to toss in, you know, we have to put a 15 or so percent chance of rain in occasionally, right? Just in case something happens. But it looks like our scholarship fund and fun with golf is going to be there for us next week. What have you been up to before we get into the 2+2 and all the good people that make it go around? What's been going on in your office there on the campuses lately?
Well, we love that our students are back on campus. We have been helping them with scholarships and getting them back in class. And, you know, we've been even planning for a scholarship social where we bring our donors to meet our students here on campus. That's going to be happening the end of this month, September the 29th. We've had our first home football game here last Thursday night. Rangers came out with a win over Colin, so that was great. We have a ribbon cutting today for our new residence hall here on campus, Calhoun Hall, so that's exciting. So lots of things have been going on in our office on campus as well.
So North Central Electric Cooperative has been kind to this program, kind to Northwest, and now let's talk about that 15th annual, I guess, Bancorp South and North Central teaming together with the 2+2 scholarship golf tournament. Can you tell us a little bit? First of all, obviously people should know by now we're talking next Thursday, but time and place and things that will be swinging the clubs and helping benefit some Northwest students?
Sure thing. First of all, we're so thankful for the partnership that we've had for 15 years with Bancorp South and North Central Electric Cooperative. They've been great in sponsoring this tournament all these years. But we have two flights. You can come out and play early at 8 a.m., or you can come in the afternoon at 1 o'clock. We'll be at Cherokee Valley Golf Club there in Olive Branch, a beautiful golf course there. And we'll have breakfast for our morning golfers. We'll have lunch for all of our golfers. And you can do that for $400 a team. That's just $100 a person. And again, that is 1 week from today, two flights, 8 a.m. and 1 p.m.
So $100 per person. It includes, right, the green, the cart, the beverages, breakfast for the morning, as you said, lunch for everybody. And then it benefits the students for Northwest and University of Mississippi there on the South Haven campus. Is that correct?
That's right. Our students there at the DeSoto Center, right there in South Haven, they can go. The scholarship tournament supports a 2+2 scholarship, and what that means is students can go to that campus, go 2 years at Northwest, get their associate's degree, and then a seamless process of going right into their 2 years at Ole Miss. To get their bachelor's degree, all right there on the DeSoto campus in South Haven. And this tournament supports scholarships for those students.
I'm sure with every golf tournament, there are contests, right? Putting, closest to the pin, things of that nature?
Exactly, exactly. And when golfers arrive, they can come early, and of course they'll have a practice range set up where they can do that. And yes, lots of prizes. We'll have some raffle items for them to purchase tickets for, and all of the profits, of course, go to the students. So they can come out and have a great time with the different contests, as you said, the raffle items. They can eat, play golf, and all benefiting students as well as they're having a good time. Businesses can come, and maybe they want to sponsor. We have sponsorship opportunities. Maybe they want to bring their customers out for a day as well. And so it really can hit so many different levels of businesses in their advertising, taking their customers out, having a good time, and helping students along the way.
And that's the main reason we want to talk about this, obviously, is helping those students to further that education. Are we getting close? I mean, our limited team availability?
We still, yes, we have a limited team availability, but there are some spots still left open. And you can call our office here. Leanne Elrod is our tournament coordinator. And if you would like to come in with a team or possibly bring your customers out for a sponsorship, you can call her at 662-560-1112. That's Leanne Elrod, our tournament coordinator, to do that.
Maybe there's a business or someone out there that heard about needing sponsorships as well. Is that the same place they need to go and talk with her?
Yes. Mm-hmm. They can call her as well.
And that, again, is 560-1112. How many years the 15th year of doing this, this is probably something that's hard to know. I bet there have been a lot of people that have been at every one and played golf in every one of these events. It's got to be something that draws people back over and over again.
Oh, it does. And we hear people all the time, we'll be talking about golf tournament. They say, oh, you mean the 2+2? So it has really encouraged along the way these golfers, because they know they're always going to have a good time at this tournament. And it's a well-run tournament. It's been around for 15 years. People recognize it, and they love to come and play. And, yes, we see returning golfers all the time that come back and play year after year.
Final information or things we need to discuss before I let you go?
We also have a Facebook page. If you just search 2+2, you will see some of our other sponsors that have been there, and also you can register there, message us there. You can message us on Facebook if you would like a team, too. I want to put a plug out here, too. Homecoming will be coming up next month, October 21st. If you are a member of the class of 1970, or 1971, we'll be recognizing you with a 50-year Golden Circle recognition. Be 50 years since they have been at Northwest. So mark your calendars for October 21st, our homecoming date.
Excellent. My friend, thanks for being on our program again. Give us some good information along the way and taking care of us for a few minutes on this program.
Absolutely, Gary Darby. Always great to speak with you.
Thank you, Patti.
Thank you. Y'all have a great day.
You too. There she is. She's been on the program now, just a professional at doing these things and talking with us about whatever it might be. In her office as Executive Director of Institutional Advancement, we were talking about the 2+2 Scholarship Golf Tournament, the 15th Annual Bancorp South and North Central Electric Cooperative 2+2 Scholarship Golf Tournament, benefiting Northwest Community College and University of Mississippi at the DeSoto Center in South Haven. It takes place 1 week from today. As she mentioned, two flights, one at 8 a.m., one at 1 in the afternoon. Depending on space, you might want to hurry up and get involved if you hadn't. And again, all the money that they get, obviously, they'll help fund the 2+2 scholarships. There will be breakfast provided in the morning for the morning flight, lunch for everybody. And, of course, you know, the $100 per person, or if you're, you know, part of a team, you got that team together, a foursome for $400 easy. It includes the golf, the card fees, goodie bags, beverages, breakfast for that morning, lunch for everybody, and an opportunity to help out some students along the way. What a great cause that is. And we thank Patti for being on our show, talking with us about it a little bit more.